Hello friends, and welcome again to our channel, The Teacher. My name is Rajiv, and today in this Excel video we will learn about using free spans in our worksheets. While working with worksheets with a large amount of data, you might fall into a very common problem, and that is when you scroll down to see other records in worksheet, the top heading row is no longer visible then, and you might actually get lost while searching for a particular set of record. What I need here is to see the top heading row all the time, doesn't matter how far I scroll down through my worksheet. To freeze a single or multiple rows in this worksheet, we will use the freeze panes command from the View tab under Window section. When you open the freeze panes drop down menu, here you have three different freeze options to choose from. As in this worksheet, I want to freeze the top heading row alone. Then I will go for the second option, that is freeze top row. And as I click on this option, you can notice a dark border is created underneath the first row, which indicates that the first row is freeze now. And if I scroll down to see other records in my worksheet, the top heading row will always be visible, which ultimately makes it easy to find a particular set of information. When you need to unfreeze the first row, just go to freeze pane section and click unfreeze spans. That's it. As with rows, you can also use freeze spans for columns as well. For instance, in the second worksheet of this workbook, which is full order summary, I have a large amount of records in rows and columns as well. What I need here is, I want to freeze the first column so I can match the order ID with product category. But when I scroll horizontally to see other columns in this worksheet, the first column is no more visible. So to freeze the first column here, I will use third option from freeze panes menu, which is freeze first column. You can immediately notice that the border between column A and column B get darker, which indicates that the first column is freeze now. And if now I scroll horizontally in this worksheet, I may still be able to see the first column. You can unfreeze the column anytime by clicking unfreeze panes from the freeze panes dropdown. But it is not necessary that you may always want to freeze the top row or first column. For instance, in the third worksheet of this workbook, you can see that here we have an additional heading above the column headings. And if I just go and use freeze first row command, then only the first row get freeze, and the actual headings in the second row that I want to freeze will not be visible as I will scroll through this worksheet. In this case, I want to freeze the first two rows of this worksheet. So to freeze more than one row, first you need to consider the active cell position. Means what your current position in the worksheet is, because the command that we are going to use now will be freezing all the rows above from your current position. As I want to freeze the first two rows of this worksheet, so I will move and will set my active cell position on the first column and third row, which is cell A3. Now, to freeze the first two rows, I will use the first command in freeze pane menu, which is actually freezes the columns and row according to active cell position. So as our active cell is A3, then the Excel will only freeze the two rows above A3 alone. Sometimes you might want to freeze more than one column or rows at the same time. Let's unfreeze everything first and then look into this scenario. For instance, in this same worksheet, I want to freeze the top two rows and first three columns from the left. This time again, I will use the same command, and before I just go and use freeze pans, I will first change my active cell position. So in this case, it will be third row and fourth column, and the active cell position will be D3. Now, if I apply the freeze pans command, and then according to the current active cell position, if I scroll vertically, then the top two rows will always be visible, and if I scroll horizontally through this worksheet, then the first three columns will always remain visible. Anytime when you no longer need to freeze any columns or rows, just go and click unfreeze pans. So this is how you can use freeze pans in worksheets with a large amount of data. I hope you will find this video useful. Do leave your suggestions and comments in the box below. Don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and have a nice day.